Hi everyone, this is Ganesh Doloka. Today we are going to learn about introductory part of cloud computing. Now, as this is the introductory part, we'll have a glance of cloud computing in this. So, before proceeding with respect to the different concepts with respect to the cloud computing, let's have a look out with respect to the definition of cloud computing. The cloud computing, we are well aware about this terminology, but if we need to define, the definition could be as follows. That is, this cloud computing, it refers to the applications and services. It means we have under this cloud computing different applications, or we may say different services that runs on the distributed network using virtualized resources. So how these applications and services are going to be there in cloud, that is with the help of distributed network. And what this is going to use? Virtualized resources. So why this thing has been said here as in a virtualized resources? Because the resources will be provided and it will be locally at different place, and virtually we are going to use through a channel, and that channel is internet. The same thing has been stated here at this place, that is, it can be accessed by a common internet protocol. So to access, what we need to know, we need to connect to the internet. So this is the formal definition of your cloud computing. That is, cloud computing refers to application and services that runs on distributed network using virtualized resources and are accessed by a common internet protocol and networking standards. So while going through this definition, we come across with the two different things, and that two different things are, one among them is abstraction and second one is virtualization. Now these are the two terminologies which are there inside this cloud computing. So let us know what exactly mean by abstraction. As we are well aware, abstraction, it means we are going to hide something. The implementation we will hide. Which type of implementation? The implementation which is there to develop this application or these services. How these are implemented, that will try to hide from the end user. So end user will be able to use only the services, but how exactly those services or those applications are implemented will not be provided through the cloud computing. So this is the terminology, we call it as an abstraction. So the same thing has been said at this place, that is, cloud computing abstracts the details of system implementation from users and developers. So users and developers will be unable to know how this thing has been implemented in the background. Only we will be able to use. Let's take an example. If we have just simple one service to perform the addition of two numbers. So now we are well aware that to perform the addition of two numbers, we need to take input from the users, and then we need to compute on the input, and we need to produce the output to the user. So there will be a GUI which will be provided in this cloud computing, through which we can provide the input and we can get the desired output. But how this thing will happen behind the scenes, how the addition will took place, that will be hidden from us. So this is the concept of abstraction. Second thing is virtualization. Now here, virtualization is nothing but the thing which we are going to use as an resources will be somewhere else, and we will virtually use it. It will not physically available at our place. So that's why this is again another terminology which is there inside your cloud computing. So that is, cloud computing virtualizes the system. How it will virtualize this? That has been stated here, that is, by pooling and sharing the resources. It means we are going to pool the resources from cloud service provider. How we will be able to pull those because they will be shared. So now here there are few examples which are stated in our textbook with respect to the cloud computing, but there are in others. Here is one that is Google. This Google company is provides cloud services. Again another one which is most famous is Azure platform. This is another which provides the cloud computing environment. Third one here is that is Amazon Web Services. Again this is one more which provides us cloud services. Now again there are different models of this cloud services and different types you may say of the services that we'll try to look out in upcoming clips. So for the sake of simplicity, in the market we may say that is Google, Azure platform, Amazon Web Services, etc. are the companies which are going to provide or which provides actually cloud services. Now we'll have a look out with respect to the cloud types. Now this cloud type mainly it has been categorized or you may say has been separated into different types by the users. One is the deployment model and another one is the service model. Now the name itself says deployment model, that is it will be on the basis of location, and service model it will be based on your services. So the same thing has been said here, that is this deployment model it refers to the location and management of your cloud's infrastructure. That is it refers to the location and management of that cloud infrastructure. So it will be based on your location actually. And another model, that is service model, this is the model which consists of a particular types of services. Now we'll have a look out which are the different types of services in the next clip, but on the basis of if someone categorize cloud on the basis of services, that model will be your service model. Now what has been said here, that is that you can access on the cloud platform. So this different types of services you can access on the cloud computing platform. So on the basis of those services it has been categorized. So these are the two types of your clouds: deployment model and service model. In the next clip we will have a glance with respect to the same in brief. Thank you very much for watching this video.